The song you just played from it is called Ask About Me. That's my favorite song off the EP, and I love that song. And you felt like you were speaking from a lot of perspective. You've been going through so much in recent time, and you've been doing so much with your music. People are talking about Ask About Me, people are talking about you. Where did that song come from? Ask About Me, what inspired the song?
What inspired the song was I wanna be real like to audio session.
Okay.
So it came from 1 PM. What's 1 PM? A distro company.
Yeah.
So I wanted to like drop a project with them. So I sent them the whole your song I have. So the only thing I heard from him like Amo will still want heat. So once I heard that, like, I feel like okay, you still want heat. Do I have his songs, but my mood was totally different from what I really want. So once they said they want heat, I want to really understand what they really want. So I feel like okay, you guys want it, which you want this song, like when you go to the club you listen to, when you're on the street you listen to. So I already have my full people ready.
Okay.
So they said, oh, but we still want something really
Different.
like something up. So like seeing like immediately they say that, okay, as mobile. I
Yeah.
went in the studio. I just want, it's not like I want to impress them, but I just want to do me still, but I want them to be comfortable because what we do together is a business.
Yeah.
That was what made me require.
Okay, so when you submitted your EP to the distro, you didn't have this song Ask About Me on it.
Yeah, I
You
didn't. I
submit
didn't. I didn't at all.
You
I
didn't have it
didn't.
on it,
Yeah.
and they said they wanted a hit song because they feel like from listening to the EP, they didn't have that Ask About Me type of song. So you had to go back to the studio to get them Ask About Me.
Yeah, though I have a hit song because I have La Pio Pio. I have different songs with you people.
Yeah.
They are like, they still like, this is something I've not done
Yeah.
that I really want.
Yeah.
So even they say that, okay, as more understand. So it's more of like the push me to record as a
So shout out to the distro for inspiring that one. On the song that's about me, you talked about Bible.
what?
You talked about Bible.
What Bible is that? What line is that?
Something about opening Bible chapter or something like that.
Bible chapter. Step on the seat. Don't push you down. Don't call yourself.
You think I don't know this song? See, yeah, it's Shefe Ma Wine Mini. Shefe Ma Wine Mini. So you mentioned like Bible, opening Bible and all of that on the song. Do you read your Bible? Do you or it's just
Why not, man? When it's done, man, you don't judge a book by its cover.
What's your favorite Bible verse?
My favorite Bible verse. You're just switching from one to
Oh
whatever.
yeah, okay, let's go back to the Bible chapter. So that Bible chapter is supposed to inspire this song, this question I'm asking you now, like off you mentioning the Bible chapter on the song. So I'm asking you, how often do you like read your Bible? And you said you do.
Is it? I don't really read my Bible like that.
Uh-huh.
But I have my Bible beside me all the time.
So where's your Bible now? Is it in the
I have
car?
in the car.
You haven't seen the car?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah. If I don't have the car, I have it on my phone.
Yeah. Oh, because I was about to ask someone to go to your car now to go read the Bible.
No, I have it on my
You have it on your
phone,
phone.
man.
You have it on your
Yeah.
phone. All right, cool. So, what is your favorite Bible verse?
Psalm 23.
Psalm 23.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not
That's the only part you know. Reception been since you dropped this body of work? Bless.
Yeah, since I dropped it, nobody was expecting you.
Yeah.
I was expecting more, but you know at times, yeah. What you love doesn't love you at times. What you expected to happen doesn't happen at times. You expect it to go. bigger than this. So if it's not going bigger than this, I will still understand, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because me and God like this, we did like finances. So when you trust?
Yeah.
Okay. I was expecting to go bigger than what's going on now.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's not really going that way to me. To other people say, it's going fine. But to me, I want it very big. But since it's not really going the way I want, like to me, yeah.
That's to you, from your perspective.
Yeah, from my own perspective, yeah. So it's making me want to do more.
Making you want to do more.
Yeah.
Making you want to do more. Okay, that's fair. And do you think that your expectation is just off standard that you set for yourself? Or do you think that, I don't know, why do you think this body of work is not doing as well as you would want it to be? Is it based on like the feedback you've gotten? Is it
because when I job,
yeah,
there's a lot of people that job, projects, singles, I know, yeah, I understand.
Mm-hmm.
And the industry now is not the way I feel like it's gonna be. The industry now is like the old ways.
What do you mean?
What I mean is the industry now is like the old ways, meaning that ways that we used to drop some that we have to go Alaba. All this and this, but now it's not like that. We don't have to call Alaba again. You have to call agriculture, call farmer, call everything. Wait,
which one is agriculture? So there's a conversation, right? I think I understand what you're trying to say. There's a conversation people are having on social media about, you know, music, about streaming numbers, about certain platforms, and saying that some people are using streaming farm. Do you think that's a thing?
Do I think?
It's a thing. Do you think it's true?
It is. I took more time to really find out. Because I don't just believe in what everybody says.
Yeah.
So me by myself, like, come down to like, okay, is this true for them? Real? You understand? So the only way I feel like it's real is there's so many songs that, like my song Ask About Me.
Yeah.
My song was like 12 on the charts when I dropped it.
Yeah.
And there's so many songs, they are number one now. It's not even blown as my song.
It's not even as blown as your song.
Yeah.
And you're okay. So it's like, how is this song number one when you're not even, when the song is not even as big or as popular as your song?
So I feel like, wow, what's going on? Then I didn't really understand.
Yeah.
No, after I took my time to
study the game,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, different people that called me on my song was number. So yeah, the song is doing well, but it remains small thing. I can't call them. See, what thing be that small thing? Where it remain though? They didn't tell me. Well, later when I found, I feel like that small thing really be top now. I swear to my God. Yeah.
So you think that the only thing that you didn't do that probably they wanted you to do was like to farm the song?
I don't even want to farm the song because at every point here, I want to know my strengths. I want to know how strong I am. If I'm doing a farming, imagine I drop a song like Ask About Me and I do it farming, or I call it agriculture. My niggas call it agriculture. I want to start buying cutlass and oak for people that does it. So whenever I see them, I'll just, this is your award. The award is.
Okay.
Is it guys cutlass? Yeah. Or is it oak?
Yeah.
So I just found out like, oh wow, I drop a song and it's number 12. I didn't go to shows like 3 weeks when I dropped it, so I didn't even know how much my song is going.
Yeah.
But I've seen different songs.
Yeah.
On number one.
Yeah.
And the number one, okay, the first time I went to show after Ask About Me, I I was in the club, so the DJ was playing songs. I swear to God, I didn't listen to, I didn't hear any song from number one to like number 10.
At the club?
In the club.
When you went to the club and DJ was playing songs, like you didn't see any of the songs that are number one to number 10.
I swear to God, they just play some where they say, you know, you're going to be number 100.
But like the song, Wait Streets Once Preserved.
Yes. So that cracked my doubt, like all the songs on, I've heard it like, all the songs on the chart, like 1 to 10 are not real, they're agriculture, as I call it. So I didn't really believe until I get to the club. So when I was in the club, I didn't even hear any song that was on the chart. Me, I believe every song on the chart is supposed to be on the street.
So I think I understand what you're saying. So you're saying that when you went to the club and you were listening to the song that DJ was playing at the club, you didn't hear the songs that are number 1 to 10 on the chart.
That's right, even to 20.
1 to 20 did not make it.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Okay. Yeah, like I didn't listen, and I'm so disappointed because I don't do music because I want people to be free. I do music because I love it.
Yeah.
So if I record a song, and the song is like number 50 on the chart.
Yeah.
It is my song. At times I'll feel like, oh, I need to do more to make this song be on. Mm-hmm. Like, but nowadays, man, no matter how what you do, man, your song is gonna be on number 100 or 200. It's gonna be there. You know why? Should I tell you?
Why?
Because there's a lot of farming. People farm to number 100.
So you went to the club seeing people vibe to song that are not number 1 to number 20 on the chart, but you are seeing DJ play the song, and I'm sure that gave you some sort of confidence in what you're doing, that regardless of what number the song is on the chart, so long as the street love it, people are going to vibe to it, right?
Yeah.
So that gives some sort of confidence.
It's not like you give me confidence, but really, I want my song to be on number 1 too.
Regardless.
No, I don't like. I don't like me. What did they call it in school?
Ojoro.
It's not Ojoro. It's not short code. It's called. It's not Mago Mago. What's it called? Like.
Report card.
It's not report card. When you do some. And I never do something for school, you say, you know, be real.
That's Ojoro.
Agberugbeso.
It's not Ojoro.
Crown.
Ojoro, do you know what Ojoro means?
Uh-huh.
Ojoro means like...
You cheated.
When you, me and you play a card and...
Yeah.
You cheated.
I fucked you up one way or the other. I
can't use F-word. Mm-hmm.
You know? Mm-hmm. The other one, you're not different, like... It's different from that one.
It's like cramming.
Like, yeah, you're attacking. This one is like, you already know what you want to do. I like, imagine I want to drop a song now and I want my song to be on number one. I already know what I want to do to make it be on number one. Now, you know what Ojoro means? Mm-hmm. Ojoro means me and you playing a game and I try to snitch you one way or the other.
Okay. I don't understand what the reference you're trying to make with the classroom and, you know, school setting, but I think what you're just trying to say, like, for you, you don't like shortcuts. You don't want to. You want to go through the right way. Release the song, let the fans determine
the one number. It's not like I want to go through that. The only reason why I want to go through the water, I want to know my strength.
You want to know your strength, and you want to know, you're honest with yourself. You want honest feedback. This is what the fans want. So if you put out this music and you allow it grow organically, you will know that this is what the fans want, and they love the song, and that's why they are streaming the music. So I get you. So on the body of work, Blessed, what's your favorite song?
I don't have a favorite song.
Mm-hmm.
I say, you know why? I love Blessed.
Mm-hmm.
I love Ask About Me.
Mm-hmm.
I love Beast and Peace.
Mm-hmm.
I love Sabi.
Mm-hmm.
I love all the songs on the track, on the EP.
Yeah. Everything works for you.
Yeah.
So you're going to, you're planning your UK tour.
Mm-hmm.
When does it start?
You know, really like my thought, okay. I have a plan for it, though. For now, you know. As I say, I want to do it in the right time.
But you're going to the UK?
Yeah.
To perform?
Yeah.
Okay, so, like, how many places?
I'm performing in Birmingham, I'm performing in London. Please, I'm performing,
excuse me, guys. Hold on, show.
I'm performing in London.
Okay.
Birmingham. I can't remember. Yeah, wow. Because even except from UK, I still have shows in Cyprus.
Okay.
As if shows in Canada. So okay. I'm just full.
It's a lot.
Yeah, a lot of updates in my head.
But is this your first time of performing in the UK?
No. I performed in the UK, and I did like 3 shows in the UK first time I was in the UK.
Okay, but are you excited to be back on the road?
Why not? I am now, no more now. You know, UK girls love me.
Mm-hmm.
They just like me because I'm a black boy. And
they
do too, but not as much as they.
As UK girls love you. So you're going back for the UK girls.
I'm going back for the UK girls because I really want to show how talented I am.
Yeah.
It's not like because of how much I can.
I mean, it's fine. It's okay. It's calm. It's calm. I understand. So tell us about the being on the road. What do you love the most about it? Performing in other parts of the world. What do you love the most about it? How excited is it to make you? What plans do you have to put in place to ensure that the being on the road is successful and just going on tour or just performing in other countries?
Performing in other countries.
Because you've performed in Nigeria, so what's the difference?
The difference from other countries is performing in Nigeria is almost like me performing to myself.
How?
Because no more Nigerians already know my words.
Okay.
They know what I can do.
Yeah.
They know, okay, nobody can do this enough.
Yeah.
But, like, too frustrating to people that have not even seen me in person.
Yeah.
It's a big difference.
Yeah.
So, whenever I'm performing out of Nigeria, things I want to do, okay, now, in the whole world, people that listen to my song most are Nigerian. So if I want to prove like I'm different to other countries, I need to like show how much I can use my voice, how much I can perform on the stage, how much time I can use on the stage.
Yeah.
So that's a difference. So performing in other countries is like me showing the other side of me. So and that's what I really want.
Yeah.
Me going to the UK now, I think I'm having a show in 11, 12, 13. What's it called? I have a show in Manchester, I have a show in Birmingham and London.
Yeah.
Who's this guy? What's this Ebon show? No.
Yeah.
No.
You're not performing inside. You're showing to different parts of the world.
So I'm performing there, and it's a big show.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna be there for real. I'm not even supposed to be there because I was supposed to have different tours even before now. But you know, all these, what do they call them? People that do shows.
Show promoters.
Show promoters, yeah. They didn't want to pick me for shows because, did I tell you?
Yeah.
Because I left the label, and if they want to reach out to me, they still go back to the label, and the label keeps saying that boy is not really okay here, like, he's going through a lot, and the show promoter believe that.
Oh.
Yeah, they do believe that because, you know. They didn't speak to me directly because you know what I know.
Yeah.
The show I'm going to, what's my phone? The show I'm going to recently is from Polo Hello, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I just want to do this. Sorry.
So the show that you're.
The show I'm going. I'm here with you.
Yes.
So the show I'm going to right now.
So.
Is for one African fest. You know why they have to call me to ask me? Yeah.
Yeah.
To ask me, bro, are you really okay? Can you do the show? And I'm like, what do you guys feel like? I'm not okay. So they told me like, liver, your left side. You're in the hospital. You know, I'm like, me not my own. Why? I just in gym by myself.
Yeah, that's fine. That's
I really understand why I've not been in the UK for long. So presently I'm going, so I let them understand. Like, it's not like I let them understand, like I'm gonna prove to everyone like more is different from what you heard online.
Yeah.
What you saw on Twitter, what you saw on TikTok, what you saw on...
I feel like your fans already know you. Like, I feel like your fans already, they know you and they trust you. They for people who follow your music and they follow everything that you're up to and everything you've been doing, I think your fans understand that you're okay and that you're fine.
Yeah, my fans do. You. My fans do. Well, most of my fans, I really understand that my fans from Nigeria.
Yeah.
I got fans in America, UK, every places, you know.
Yeah.
The way my Nigerian fans understand is not the same way.
The ones outside of Nigeria understand. And that's fine. I feel like once you go on tour now, or once you stop performing in all these countries and they see you live on stage, they would absolutely understand that. That would be like a very good way for them to connect with you. That's the good thing about being on the road.
Yeah.
Yeah. So shout out to you, Mohbad. I'm looking forward to this, your tour, and you know, the countries that you're performing. I hope we'll be able to get videos on social media. And your music, the body of work you just dropped, The Blessed, is doing well. Ask About Me is a jam and a half. And I'm sure the TikTok guys already, they're Koje on social media. Do you have a dance for you though? Do you have a dance?
Oh, I know.
Do you know how to dance?
I don't really know how to dance.
You don't really know how to dance like that. Yeah. But it's calm. Thank you so much, Mohbad, for coming today on the show. I hope you have a good day. I hope you enjoy yourself.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
Are you looking at me? What do you think about me?
What do I think about you?
Yeah. What do you feel like? What do you feel like I am?
What do I feel like you are?
Yeah.
Wait, ask that question again. I don't understand the question.
No, really, like from where we're taking from, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you know, me and you met now.
Yes, now this was the first time. Like, we've met on this point before. You were my.
Why? It's not like I wasn't happy this song is out, and it's not like I was not happy because I gave Rexy, but I was not just happy because I doubted the song.
So you own the song and you gave it to Rexy?
Yeah.
Because you didn't believe in the song.
It's not like I didn't believe in the song, but I just feel like this one to take this song, those are my other point. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I'm tired of saying that we are the number one podcast, because facts should not be
repeated. That's facts only.
Thank you very much.
But yeah, please, I need to say this. Well, like, you know, I feel my heart is so warm. I feel so good. I just see all the love you're sending me on YouTube. Like, I'm emotional. If you don't like, you guys will appreciate me. The listeners do, and that makes my heart so warm. Shout out to all the men who see my work. Yeah.
I just want to remind you that we're not dating you.
That's your business.
I want to remind all the men seeing our work that she's in a serious relationship.
Don't let this thing.
It's going to be 3 years old this
serious
year.
Serious relationship, right. Headed towards marriage.
Hey, chill, bro. Chill.
Headed towards marriage. Keep that shreddy colors.
In case you do not know, except on Bumble.
Bumble, my nigga.
Bumble.
I'm on Bumble.
Melody, you're not cultural.
Dating app.
Yes,
how many are you on? Bumble, Tinder?
No, I've left Tinder and Badoo because there's a lot of ras babes there. A lot of very ras babes, a lot of unemployed women. I know how I
feel. Mohbad, have you ever been on any of this podcast?
Have you been on any of
this podcast?
Ever?
I don't think you.
Come on! So you hear that? Did you hear that?
We just started.
This
is just like 5 seconds in.
Yeah, but facts don't need to be repeated. No,
please, Mohbad.
You know. When was the last time you chased a girl?
Maybe when I was in secondary school.
So your game has been on for a year.
No, I don't explain John.
You don't find John chasing girls?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know.
So you don't think that, you don't believe in applying pressure when you like someone as a man?
Why is he applying pressure?
Yeah, I'm saying that.
Sorry.
I'm not liking girls, like I don't even, because I don't know who likes me, and I don't even know who I like. It's crazy now, you understand?
Yeah, you can't tell which is real.
Yeah, who is real.
So you're saying all these women are not real, bro?
I can't know you, they're not, you know.
I feel like superstars say that they're not.
What do you want them to say?
Yeah,
this street is cold, bro.
But now, so the way you as superstars, of course, you feel like it is easier for you to get the, because it's more difficult for you to find who is in love with you or who is in love with you. Does that make you feel some type of way, like, even as a superstar, like love and all of that?
When you superstar thing is still getting into my business, I used to feel like, I can get any girls, you know, any trip. Number one, at the point, you know, that's not the main thing.
Mm.